be an election observer, one must be trained in a course organized by a professional organization. Let's see how they are trained. In the training, ANFEL will conduct a series of sessions for observers designed to provide them with relevant information about the election law and electoral system of a country, as well as facts about the geography, history and culture of the country where the election will be held. It is during this training that observers also receive observation forms, caste stickers, official accreditation issued by the country's election management body, handbooks, jackets, caps and a medical kit before their deployment. Tasks upon arriving in the province and election constituency before election day. Election observers have to report themselves to local electoral officials and have to meet all stakeholders when they arrive to the province or the constituency. Observers have to always arrive on time and wear their uniform, especially their identity card and accreditation cards. Observers have to dress properly with respect to local cultures. Observers should concentrate on the issues dealing with elections and should not go beyond the questions that should be raised to get necessary information on the electoral situation. Don't fall asleep or smoke cigarettes while meeting or interviewing people. If observers want to record the conversation, they should ask for permission before the interview starts and should always take notes during interview. Observe electoral campaigns and the performance of EMB officials, as well as observe the advance voting if that is taking place. Monitor all parties while they are organizing their electoral campaigns. Read newspapers, watch television to keep up with the ongoing situation. Even though observers may not always understand the local language, never take any gift from politicians nor have a meal with them. Such behaviors are considered as a bribe to observers. Observers who are deployed as male and female pairs must be accommodated in separate rooms and do not have permission to go into each other's rooms. Advanced preparation is a must. Observers should go to bed early and prepare all equipments to be ready the next day, particularly mobile phones, cameras, and adequate fuel for the observer's vehicle. Action on election day. Use the checklist to determine if the polling station is prepared according to EMB regulation. This would include checking things such as whether the voter list is provided to voters outside the polling station. Observe the situation outside and inside the polling station. If observers are not allowed to go inside, they must observe from the outside. Take a look to see if there are any peculiar situations such as a vote buying, free transportation for voters, voters being escorted to vote, whether some voters are underage or someone uses another identity card to get a ballot paper they are not entitled to. Take note of all details along with the name and location of the polling station. Observers should talk to voters around the polling station to survey their understanding of the electoral process and to see if there are any problems. If there is violence, observers must stay away from the incident, always keeping in mind that observers are not news reporters who are seeking front page exclusive reports or who must take a risk for good photos. Personal safety for the observer and the support team must come first. Observe how media does their report. If they come to interview the observer, observers are allowed to tell them only their own view and are restricted to speak about what they know in their constituency only. Discussion of the overall situation is reserved for coordinators in the headquarters. Action after voting is closed. Light in the polling station must be sufficient. The vote count should not be done immediately after the closing. It should come after the counting of the number of unused ballot papers to ensure that the total ballot papers delivered to the station is the correct number. Note how the official makes the announcement of valid and invalid ballots, as well as no vote ballots. Take note of whether there is transparency during the vote count. Follow the ballot box and the documents transfer by car. Note down the type of vehicle they use, from where and where the vehicle moves, and if there are any stops along the way, such as stopping for dinner or stopping for a family visit before proceeding to the final destination.